Today we're working with some wonderful new journals from Strathmore. With softcover and hardcover versions, different styles of paper, and different sizes, you're sure to find one that fits the way that you work. We'll be offering these journals with special introductory pricing, so be sure to check them out on the website once you finish viewing this video. There are multiple paper options in these new journals, both in the soft-bound and in the hard-bound copies. For today, we're going to work with two, the one with the 90-pound mixed media paper in it, and it's marked as mixed media, and then the other one is 140-pound cold-press watercolor paper. And interestingly enough, though these are available in both hardbound and softbound, you'll notice these are both mixed media. This is the softbound one, and it's 5.5 by 8 inches. This is the hardcover one, and it's 5.5 by 8.5 inches. So they're similar, but they're not identical between the soft and the hardcover styles. I believe that this is the same paper or very similar to what's in the Strathmore Visual Journals, and if you've used them, you'll know just how nice it is. One of the real nice things about this is that the bindings on these are both sewn and then glued. So if you are unhappy when you see liquid seep between the bindings from one page spread to another, you'll be thrilled to know that I have not yet experienced that. I'm working with, this is the soft-bound watercolor journal, and it's, I want to say it's 8.5 by 5.5, or 8 by 5.5, but it's a horizontal or a landscape style version, and I soaked the heck out of this, and because it's glued, you're not seeing, I mean, this is a mess from where it sort of, I was making a mess as I was working, but you're not seeing this bleeding through to other page spreads. And that can be a little bit disappointing when it happens in other journals. You work on something that you're really happy with, and then maybe you turn the page or you move along a couple of pages, and the next thing you know, you've got color that's crept in here, and sometimes it's crept up in enough that it really spreads out and it's very noticeable on your prior page. Now, perhaps the most important thing about these journals is for a limited period of time, probably through the end of the year, 2013, we're going to offer these at an introductory special. They're going to be between 35 and 36% off of regular retail, so that's a significant savings. I will continue to bring them in and have them for those prices as long as I can get them for those prices. I'm going to show you a little bit about the way these papers work. You'll be happy to know that if you're a fan of the Dilusions ghosting technique, works perfectly well on both the watercolor and the mixed media versions of this paper. I'm going to begin with the hardbound mixed media version of the journal. Now, like all hardcover books, which is essentially what this is, you see this page sticking up here? These do not necessarily want to lay flat initially. The binding is such that it really wants to hold it in this closed position. So here's what I do, and those of you who are book lovers, and I'm among you, you might gasp at this, but you really do need to do this. I'm going to hold this in a V, then I'm going to hold the pages, and I'm actually going to bend this back. I need to get this binding flat enough and open enough so I can work with it. Now, I've been doing this for the last few days, and even though I'm really cracking that binding to get it to lay flat, I am not seeing leak through. So I'm hoping that that's going to be the case as I go along. I know that there are times when I get disappointed because something I worked on that I really like ends up getting mucked up the next time I work in the journal, let's say on an adjacent page or something close. So I don't believe that that's going to happen here. And now that I've got this open, I'm going to just go ahead and I'm going to miss some color on here. And I'm going to use Dilusions. It seems only fair that if we're going to use Dye's technique, we should use her products. This is just some scratch paper that I'm going to put in here. It's just inexpensive printer paper. It kind of keeps the overspray to a minimum. Again, I'm just going to give this a press to get this to lay flat. I'm going to work with fresh lime, and I'm just going to come in and spray some here. I'm going to work with vibrant turquoise. And then I'm going to come in with some After Midnight. And as you can see, I'm using my typical watered-down versions of this. I think if I can find the bottle of After Midnight, I want to come in with some of the non-diluted version to just put over the top. And of course, though I had it here 30 seconds ago, it has subsequently disappeared. Never mind, we'll just work without it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to come in and blot out all this excess color. If I had been thinking ahead, I would have had something that I could have put on top of that. I'm just going to wipe this up, and I'm smearing the color, but I really don't care. I don't want to let this puddle in here because it will creep back out, and I'll show you that in 1 second. You can see back here something that I worked on. Though I mopped this up, I did not mop really well in the center, and it did wick out. Now, it didn't wick through to the next section or the next pages, but it did wick out from here. So I do want to warn you about that so that you go ahead and pick that up. Now, I'm making a mess here because my hands are dirty and the page is still damp. But having said that, now I can come in and I can show you the ghosting technique. This is one of the new Dilution stencils. It's called, I think, Staggered Brick or something along those lines. And I'm going to very lightly mist through sections of this with some water. Then I'm going to turn this over and I'm going to kind of do the reverse print over here. We've all seen Dye Demo this, and I've done it a number of times. It's a technique that I actually use quite often in my journals because it's a great one. So I'm going to give this just a moment so that the water can work its magic. And you can see the lightening that's already going on here as the water starts to lift some of that color off. Generally, this needs between 30 and 40 seconds. It always seems like forever when I'm standing here filming and waiting because I don't want to make you wait. But you do have to allow enough time for the water to work and for the technique to actually happen. This has probably been long enough now, so I'm just going to mop this up, and there is my ghosted image. And on this side, I'm going to get the reverse of it. Now I can see that I've got dark blocks as opposed to the light blocks here, and the background has been lifted up. So this works really well. The technique works in both this mixed media paper and in the watercolor version, and that's what I'm going to show you next. This time I'm going to work with the softbound journal, and you can see that these covers are totally flexible, very different from that lovely hardbound one, and you would expect that because this is an entirely different style. This is the one with 140-pound watercolor paper, and it's horizontal in orientation. And I've got this set up just as I did the last one. I've got my scratch paper here to try to control the overflow a little bit. And this time I'm going to work with colors straight from the bottle. I have Pure Sunshine, Funky Fuchsia, and Cherry Pie. So the process is basically the same, but what you're going to see this time is that the colors are going to be far deeper. And this time I'm going to mimic more what Dye does when she does this. I'm going to put the colors on one page, and then I'm going to flip it over and smoosh them around. So in comes some of the Cherry Pie, and then the Funky Fuchsia. And again, I'm just going to do half of this. I think I'm going to put a little fuchsia there. Then I'm going to, ordinarily I would put some water on here, but there's enough liquid on the page that I'm not feeling like I have to. And you can see it, it's kind of scooching out the edges as I press this down to sort of get this Rorschach-like blot as you go across here. And again, how pretty is that? Now I do need a little bit more of the Funky Fuchsia, so I'll do that here, but I'll open that up again. And you get this kind of cool patterning that's going on. So let me get this paper out of the way. Just put that to one side, and I'll come in with the paper towel, and I'm going to absorb that excess color. Just kind of clean up a little bit of the overspray here, and this time I'm going to use, this is the new Dilutions, you know what, I've got a little bit here I need to clean up. This is the new Dilutions Flower Medley Stencil. Really, really a nice design. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to ghost on one side, and because this is lifting a little bit, because it's wet, I'm just going to hold this down with my finger. So I'm going to take my spray bottle with some plain water in it, and I'm going to spritz there, and then I'll come over and I'll turn it and I'll print the reverse side here. Again, I'm going to give this just a moment to do its thing, but you already see what happens. This is such a cool technique. Let me just wipe this off while this is doing its thing, and I think I'm going to put a little bit in this corner right here too, and I'm going to deliberately spray around the border or the perimeter of this stencil so I get kind of a different look. Just kind of tap that off there, and again I'm going to give this a moment. You can see the lifting going on, the ghosting going on here. So I'm going to wipe this off without actually touching that piece that I just did, and again, this is such a cool technique. Provides really, really nice results. Here's my original that I turned over and printed the reverse of, and this piece should be ready to go. Close enough, it could have probably used a smidge more time, but you see how you get this kind of aurora around the perimeter of that stencil. Now this time, rather than jump on immediately to something else, again, I'm just going to come in and blot this excess out of the binding. What I want to do is I want to dry this, and I'm going to take this a couple of steps further. Let me bring in my heat tool, and I'm going to dry this. this spread is dry now, and so my next step, a lot of times when I am working on the background of a journal page, is to do one of two things, or perhaps both, is to pick up another stencil, and I like glimmer, as you all know, and so I'm going to come in and use this other stencil, and this is one of my Perfect Pearls mixes, and it's yellow, so it's going to really probably jump off the page if I put it in certain areas. So let me come in and let's do a little bit along the side here. And I'm just going to grab another piece of paper and I'm going to use it to mask off areas that I don't want to spritz through. So I'm going to kind of, well, I'll have to move it. I'm going to do this because I want to catch, you know what, I think I'll do this. I think I'm just going to bring this down the border. Maybe that will be fun. So again, I'm going to shake up my mix and let me move this to where you can see it. And now I'm just going to come in and lightly spritz through there. And when you, I lift this up, I can see this. I don't know if you can. I just need to clean this up. But I'm getting this really cool border of leaves here. Let me bring in, actually, let me bring in this really fun flower medley again. And this time, up in this area, I think I'll bring in my funky fuchsia. And I'm just going to spritz through the stencil. And again, such fun colors, such fun patterns and techniques. And let me clean this up again, let me dry this, and then I want to show you something that I oftentimes do, and I'm going to use the new Dilutions ink spray pad at the same time, but I do need to dry this. This is dry now, and I actually came in while I was drying and I spritzed some more of the Perfect Pearls through the Flower Medley stencil. I figured I was working and drying, I could get that done all at once. And you can see the glimmer of the Perfect Pearls here, and you can see it here. Now, this background is really starting to take shape, and again, this paper is just so wonderful to work on. Strathmore does make fabulous papers, and this 140-pound watercolor version is really thick and sturdy. So I'm going to bring in one of my Dilutions ink spray pads, and those of you who watched that video will remember that I made several of these, and I marked them on a piece of masking tape with what's on there. Now, one of the things that I've discovered is when these sit for a period of time, they do dry out, but the best part is all you have to do is come in and mist this with water, which I did a couple of minutes ago, and this pad will come right back to life. You don't have to add any more ink sprays, you just have to moisten what's already in there to get the color activated again. This is a fun Hero Arts stamp. It's called Single Burst. And when you look at this in proportion to this page spread, it actually looks pretty big. But sometimes it's fun to really get in there and work with some bigger, proportionally, some bigger imagery or some bigger background elements. It just kind of gives your eye a little bit of a place to rest, or it can actually draw your eye right to one area of the page. And depending on how frequently you stamp this and how close together you put them, or maybe you only put one or two in there, then your eye is immediately drawn to them. So this is Bubblegum Pink, Postbox Red, and After Midnight. I want to get in here and pick up some of this After Midnight color. I think it's going to really jump off this page. And you can see that I've got color on the stamp now. So I'm just going to come in and I'm going to press it on here. And how cool is that? Again, with that After Midnight, it just leaps off the page at you. So I'm going to basically do the same thing and I'm going to utilize those colors again so that I get some really fun effects here. You don't have to stamp all the way on. You can kind of stamp off the page too. Now let me just wipe this off on some paper towel and let me come over here to these other colors and see how they look. Now this is going to look totally different because I've got none of the After Midnight in there, but on there it goes, and it's kind of faint, but once this dries you'll be able to see it. Let me see if I can get this done in this lighter area and see if it shows, and you can see a little bit more in there. But you see how cool these burst effects are, how they draw your eye to the page, or they kind of leap off because of the contrast in color. I think I'm going to put one of these darker versions over here. And now I have a page, or a spread rather, with a background that's ready for me to collage anything on there. I could come in and rubber stamp on here. I could take some collage elements. I could stamp some figures, whether they're Dilutions or some of the really fun ones from Stampatique Originals. I can stamp them, and what I would be to do that on 90-pound watercolor paper, color them in, and then I can collage on here. And even though this is cold press, there's some texture to it. It's easy enough to come in with a Pitt pen or a Micron pen, jelly roll pens, and then start to doodle or to journal on here and do all kinds of fun things. I want to finish today by talking about the next steps that I would ordinarily take if I were working to complete this journal spread. I'm back in the 140-pound watercolor version of the journal. This is the horizontally oriented one with the soft cover. And I really, really like this a lot. I like this format, and I love this paper. Even though it's cold press and it's not perfectly smooth, I can rubber stamp on here with no difficulty. I can use my beloved Pitt pens on here with no difficulty. You can see that I've started a border, and it goes along really well. I don't have any difficulty. The pens hold up. The paper doesn't pill, and it's not bleeding through to the next area, which makes me very happy. Rubber stamping, again, no problem. I have some Jelly Roll metallic pens here, and they work beautifully on here as well. Now, obviously, this is the watercolor version of the paper. The mixed media journals have the 90-pound mixed media paper in there, and I know that they're going to work just as well. A little bit lighter in weight, but because it's not cold press, it's a smoother finish. So if you're someone who enjoys Zentangle and tangling, that mixed media version would work beautifully. It's nice, smooth paper, and I know you won't have any difficulty with it. In fact, I know that you could use this watercolor version if you wanted to tangle in it as well. With a little bit of texture on the page, obviously you might have to pay a little bit more attention, but at the end of the day, it will work perfectly. Now, obviously, as I said earlier, we're going to have these for 35% to 36% off of retail through the end of 2013, and I'll have as many of the paper and size options as I can get my dirty little hands on. As you can see, I'm a mess here from working, and I want to have these for you. They're going to make great Christmas gifts, whether you give them away or you give them to yourself. I hope you have as much fun working with these wonderful journals as I did.